Hi friends, it's been a while since I filmed a video and been even longer since I filmed a what I eat in a day video, so I thought I would show you what I ate on this particular day. I started my morning at a breakfast event with Dig In and Matcha Bar. Before I got there, I actually had a couple of bananas and then I had a little protein snack ball, but as you can see, they had tons of different matcha latte options, and of course, we started off with a matcha latte each. So I actually had the sea salt maple latte with oat milk, and my friend Alyssa, who I went to the event with, had a rose matcha latte, and both were really, really delicious. The flavors that were available were amazing, but there wasn't very much vegan and gluten-free food available, so we ended up kind of just having mostly lattes, which we didn't mind because we both love matcha. So we headed upstairs to check out some of the food options that they had available. They had a couple of things. They had this matcha donut bite, which was supposed to be vegan and gluten-free, but I now think was only vegan because I didn't feel too great after eating one of them. I will say it was really delicious though, and of course tasted like matcha, which I love. Some of the other options they had were avocado toast, but again on non-gluten-free bread, and then this beautiful rose latte. And then we both took another matcha to go. I had the vanilla almond and Alyssa had, I believe, the sea salt maple one. For lunch, I went to Champ's Diner. I actually went with one of my friends, Chris, who was in town for a meeting that we went to together, and we happened to be in Brooklyn, so I thought we'd stop at Champ's Diner because he'd never been before. If you aren't familiar, it's this amazing vegan sort of diner style food. They have everything from breakfast to savory foods, and I got the basic bowl actually and a side of tofu scramble. So inside my bowl is just brown rice, broccoli, beans, carrots, avocado, and he got the vegan breakfast slam, which looks a lot more interesting than mine, but it was delicious and just what I wanted. Then we headed to our meeting, which was also in Brooklyn, like I said, and we took a little drive there, and the weather wasn't too great this day. After our meeting, we had some cinnamon snail donuts as kind of like a dessert or a snack. Chris had never been here either, and I actually found two gluten-free donut varieties, so I naturally got one of each, and he took some to go back to Philly with him. So the one I had was a maca cinnamon donut, and then the other flavor I had was this simple raspberry glazed donut, and both were really, really delicious. They were kind of more of a cake donut texture, which is really common, especially with gluten-free donuts. It's difficult to get that fluffy texture, but they're both delicious. For dinner, I just made some really simple collard wraps using collard leaves as sort of a tortilla or a wrap in place of what you would normally use. It's a really, really easy way to get in extra veggies. So I like to add some kind of base veggie. Usually I use sprouts or I use purple cabbage, and then I also added some lentil sprouts, which have really decent amount of protein and a nice flavor. I also added some regular alfalfa sprouts because I love the flavor of them. And then I added some steamed Japanese pumpkin. And I topped it off with a sprinkle of this everything bagel seasoning, which is so delicious. It was kind of a random combination, actually. And I added avocado, of course. Then I rolled it up to make this kind of wrap. Normally I would chop it into pieces, but they were sort of loose this time around. So this is what they turned out like. And I'm gonna insert a picture here of what they look like when I make them on a better day. So that is everything I ate today. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this. I promise I'll be back with more videos very, very soon. Bye.